what are the Faraday's experiments. Now there is a coil. This is the coil. I want to send the current through the coil. To send the current through the coil, what we shall connect? Battery is to be connected. Battery is connected, there is a current through the coil, no doubt. But without connecting a battery, how can I produce the current? Whether the current is produced or not, it can be checked by galvanometer. Suppose the galvanometer is connected like this. What is the needle of the galvanometer? This is the needle of the galvanometer. Now this is called, what to say, galvanometer. By means of anything, by doing anything, we want to produce the current in the coil. Then what is the first experiment? Right? Michael Faraday took a magnet. Magnet north and south. If the magnet is rushed towards the coil, right, there is a deflection in the galvanometer. He observed that as the magnet is rushed towards the coil, during the rushing only, there is a deflection in the galvanometer. Suppose the magnet is moved towards the coil in 0.1 seconds. During the 0.1 seconds only, there is a deflection in the coil. Suppose before rushing, before moving, the magnet is at rest, the coil is at rest. There is no deflection in the galvanometer. There is no deflection in the galvanometer means there is no current in the circuit. Therefore, as long as the right magnet is rushing towards the coil, there is a deflection in the coil. Now here, this is called, what to say, magnet. North pole and south pole. Right? As the magnet is rushing towards the coil, there is a deflection. Suppose as the magnet is moving away from the coil, there is an opposite deflection. Right? Suppose if the magnet is moving with a somewhat increased speed, then the deflection is again more. Therefore, here Michael Faraday's first experiment, he has taken a magnet at the coil. This is the magnet, this is the coil. As the magnet is moving towards the coil, or the magnet is moving away from the coil, or magnet is at rest, as the coil is moving, as the coil is away from the magnet, again there is a deflection in the coil. There is a deflection in the galvanometer. That shows there is a current. That means finally he can conclude that if the relative motion between the magnet and the coil is maintained, there is a deflection in the galvanometer. That means there is a current in the coil. Right? This is called electromagnetic induction fundamental experiment. Now, here in this case, the coil is there. As the magnet is moving towards the coil, as the magnet is moving away from the coil, by keeping the magnet is constant, as the coil is moving away from the magnet, or the coil is moving towards the magnet, in all the four cases, there is a deflection in the galvanometer. That shows there is a current in the coil. Finally, in a single sentence, right, magnet is there. Next one, there is a coil. Between the magnet to the coil, there is a relative motion. As the magnet is under relative motion with the coil, or let us say magnet and coil, both are under relative motion, there is a deflection in the galvanometer. There is a deflection in the galvanometer means there is a current in the coil. This phenomena is called electromagnetic induction. Now, what is the reason behind this one? What is the reason behind this one? Suppose let us consider for understanding purpose, this is the magnet. Right? This is called North Pole, this is called South Pole. Now, around the magnet, there is a magnetic field. There is a magnetic field means magnetic lines of forces. The magnetic lines of forces, North Pole to the South Pole, North Pole to the South Pole, North Pole to the South Pole, North Pole to the South Pole. These magnetic lines of forces are closed curves. Magnetic lines of forces are closed curves. Now, that is magnetic lines of forces are like this. Magnetic lines of forces are like this. Now, there is a coil. This is the coil. Through the coil, how many number of magnetic lines of forces? 1 and 2. Suppose, if the coil is moving towards the magnet, this is the coil. In the first case, what is the flux? 1, 2. Magnetic flux. As the coil is moving towards the magnet, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. Therefore, flux is, 9. That means, as the magnetic flux linked with the coil changes, there is a induced EMF in the circuit. Because of induced EMF, there is a potential difference. Because of potential difference, there is a current. Because of the current, there is a deflection in the galvanometer. Right? What is the first experiment? Right? Magnet and coil. Both are under relative motion. Right? Both are under relative motion. What happens? There is a deflection in the galvanometer. As there is a deflection in the galvanometer, what does it mean? There is a current in the coil. Right? After doing so many number of experiments, finally he concluded that if the flux linked with the coil changes, there is an induced EMF produced in the coil. That means here, this is the bar magnet. Around the bar magnet, there is a magnetic field. In the magnetic field, there are magnetic lines of forces. Magnetic lines of forces are there. There is a magnetic flux. Right? The coil is here initially. Right? As the coil is here, what is the flux passing through for understanding purpose too? As the coil is moving towards the magnet, flux passing through the coil is increased. Right? Flux passing through the coil is increasing means what is the flux passing through the coil? 9. In moving from one position to other position, flux passing through the coil is increased. Suppose the coil is moving from this position to this position, flux is decreased. That is, don't bother, either flux increases or flux decreases. Flux increases or flux decreases. That is said to be there is a change in flux. As there is a change in magnetic flux linked with the coil, there is an induced EMF. Because of the induced EMF, there is a potential difference. Because of the potential difference, there is a current. Because of current, there is a deflection in the galvanometer.